give back to the paying. This means that the rich ones have to pay for the poor, because the most of the emissions have been caused by the rich world. This we call climate justice. We also want our local governments to step in. They have to step up their measures, and this with urgency. We want them to make a pathway towards less carbon emissions, also with a net zero emissions by 2050. Some measures I can think of, but I'm not really a specialist, but some things I can think of is, let's aim for more and better public transportation. Check the emissions from buses and trucks. Convert energy plants to clean energy plants. Start large recycling programs. And let's applaud for the smallest ones. They are joining us. So the ideas for the local governments, start good recycling programs. There's upcycling, but not recycling yet. Protect our local nature from destruction. Start reforestation plans, just to name a few. But we can ask of international and national governments to do something, but we have to do something too. We have a responsibility too. We have to change our ways. We have to start consuming less, or at least differently. We have to start reducing the things you buy. Like, every time you have to think, do I really need this? If it's broken, can it be repaired? Can somebody else use it? Or can I reuse it in another way? The other big thing you can do is eat less meat. Turn the airco up a bit. Start growing own vegetables. There's plenty of things you can do. And start planting trees. You might ask, is there still hope? And the answer is yes. Scientists tell us that if we start acting now collectively and start severe and urgent measures now, we can turn this around. Thus, we have to act now, now, now. The other thing you can do is educate yourself. Find the science. It's not so difficult to find. Unite behind the science. Talk to the people around you. Talk to your family and friends. And make them climate activists too.